statements by the Green Dress. Manifest and light the diamonds for finger of Shri Narayan Guruji to deliver his guest remarks. Excellency, yesterday, in my very young man, that's why at the Republic of Kyrgyzstan, ladies and gentlemen, members of the media, I extend a warm welcome to President Obama and his delegation in India. Kyrgyzstan is a valued friend and a strategic partner in Asia. President Obama himself is very familiar with India. We are indeed delighted to have the opportunity to host him today. In India, we deeply appreciate his leadership and contribution to strengthening our bilateral relationship. Our strategic partnership is built on a foundation of mutual respect, trust, and shared interests in regional security and development. Our countries and societies also enjoy a natural affinity anchored in deep-rooted shared history and heritage. Our cultural, religious, and linguistic intermingling from the past has carried into the world and friendship that characterizes our people-to-people linkages today. Friends, this is a and I had fruitful discussions earlier today. We assess the broad progress achieved and the different pillars of our bilateral engagement, including our partnership in defense and security. India and Kyrgyzstan live in an extended neighborhood that continues to face multiple security challenges and threats. The threat from terrorism endangers not just our two countries. It starts a long shadow of violence and instability over the entire region. Combating terrorism has therefore been an important area of our cooperative engagement. We appreciate Kyrgyzstan's role in the Central Asian region and the mainstream against forces of extremism, radicalism, and terrorism. As our government and I agree today, the stronger action on this front based on mutually agreed priorities. We will do this at multiple levels, through reinforcing our bilateral security cooperation, to greater training capability building and information activities, and through active coordination in regional and multilateral contexts. India's membership of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization will be a valuable platform to work closely on regional security and counter-terrorism efforts with Kyrgyzstan. As you know, and I also exchange views on the developments in the region. We agree that peace, stability, and prosperity in Afghanistan are important for the region. India and Kyrgyzstan are driving our steadfast support of the Afghan people and their aspirations for a peaceful and prosperous nation. Friends, President and I agree on the need to increase the scope and scale of our economic engagement, especially rail and investment traffic. In this context, hybrid power, information technology, pharmaceuticals, and healthcare would be areas of priority.
seeking to develop the existing port and transport infrastructure and connecting it through road and rail network to Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, and Central Asia. In this respect, we will work to build rail and port distance to Chabahar Port in Iran. India is also engaged in facilitating the international North-South transport corridor with other members, including Tajikistan. Our planned accession to the Ashgabat Agreement will further help in linking us to Tajikistan and Central Asia. India and Tajikistan enjoy a evolving partnership in capacity and institutional building, including under the Indian Technical and Economic Cooperation Training Program. As I have known, and I agree on sustaining and strengthening this partnership. Friends, next year we will commemorate the 25th anniversary of establishment of diplomatic relations between India and Tajikistan. I am encouraged by the wide-ranging agenda for action that President Rahman and I have set for our countries during this visit. I further expect that the agreements concluded today and our discussions will help boost practical cooperation in different sectors between India and Pakistan. I once again welcome President Rahman and wish him a very pleasant stay. Thank you very much. I thank the Prime Minister for his statement.